everyone. Welcome to this episode, How to Import Shapefile and Imageries to Google Earth in the series of GIS and Remote Sensing. This series is brought to you by the Faculty of Forestry, the University of British Columbia. I'm Hai Dali. Google Earth is famous for its ability to display satellite imagery globally. Forestry companies also prefer to use it to present geospatial data in office and fields. So how to display the vector and the raster data in Google Earth? There are two ways to do it. First, direct import data into Google Earth. Second, convert it to KML and load to Google Earth. KML file was created for Google Earth and now become an international standard data format. Google Earth has three different versions: web, mobile, and desktop. All of them can open KML file, but only desktop versions or Google Earth Pro support other non-KML data, including Shapefile, Geotiff. Before trying to open our first data, I'd like to clarify the add function to ArcGIS users. The add functions can be found here, or maybe you can find here this icon. It does not import existing data like ArcGIS add data function, but create new points, polygons, or lines. So it does nothing with this video's test to import data. Now let's try to load a shapefile. Here we can choose either open data or import. They are same. Click open, find the data location, and select the format. And this time we want to open the shapefile. Click open. Before the data loaded, and the systems to pop up a message because the shapefile contains more than 2500 features. So Google has provided the options for us to load the data. The first option is import the sample, which means that they will randomly select some of the data to load on the Google Earth, or restricts to the view, which means that Google Earth only load the data inside these windows. Any data outside of this window, Google Earth will not load. And the third one, obviously, is load all, doesn't matter how large it is. Let's try to restrict this to view. Now you may notice that the Google Earth sent another notification that only 69 features were imported. And let's select no for this one. It's just a part of the coastline around the Vancouver. Well, however, this data is the whole coastline of the BC. It's this one. So Google Earth just loaded this small piece of the data. We can load the entire shapefile, but it will dramatically slow down the performance of Google Earth. If possible, it's better to dissolve or simplify the feature before opening it in Google Earth. In our case, however, the polygon included many independent island coastline, which make this method doesn't change loss. Now let's try to open some image. In this case, we're going to select a Landsat image. Select the Geotiff. Open. Same as Shapefile, Google Earth also provides several options to open large size image. First is create a super overlay. Google Earth will divide the whole image into small pieces and create an individual KMZ file. Scale will reduce the resolution. Crop. Crop only shows a small piece of the image, and this image will be presented at the full resolution. Let's try this function first. Click the center of the window. For example, we want to load around the Vancouver, just click here. Now it's done, and only load this area. So what about the super overlay? Let's look at an example. After we select the super overlay, Google has created a separate CAMZ file here. And let's try to open one CAMZ file. Now you can see the resolution is full resolution, but the size is just a small piece of. If we want to see the whole image, we need to load all the CAMZ files under the super overlay folder. Directly open image may be not the best way to display images on Google Earth. Let's try a different way. Suppose that we want to display the images on Google Earth. We just want to display the Canada part. So first, what we do is to extract the Canada part, export the layer to CAMLR file. Once it's done, then we can go to the folder to find the CAMLR file. Double-click the CAMZ file, and it will be automatically loaded to the Google Earth. This is exactly what we saw in ArcGIS. According to what we saw, for most cases, the best way to open images is to convert the data to CAMLR or CAMZ file. So does the shapefile. It will be even better to simplify or reduce the data size before loading the data. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us. Thanks for your watching.